please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind. Right away. Now, or sooner... You are listening to WGRF Grafton Radio. I am your host, the Mayor of Grafton. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind, just come see me right away. As in now or sooner...
Don't face the wasteland without the proper supplies. Free supply here, citizens. Authorized to trade supplies and equipment. If you have supplies to trade, I can be of service. Thank you. Morgantown Airport has fallen. Avoid the area at all costs. Scorched threat is extreme. Do not attempt any rescue. The final stand.
Thank you.
I am authorized to trade supplies and equipment.
Log, Grafton. The mayor of Grafton used to be the automated assistant, and it's gone completely mad. Still trying to run the town. Even holds elections for itself. We built these machines to do things without us, and they have. Might be useful if I played along.
Time once again to put aside all you think you know, all you believe to be true. Time to open your mind to the strange, bizarre, and sometimes terrifying world that exists in the shadows and fringes of our own, where myth, legend, and rumor are made real. Yes, it's time for more thrilling Tales from the West Virginia Hills. Tonight's episode, The Beast of Grafton, is brought to you by Dandy Boy Apples. Apples so good, they never go bad. And remember, an apple a day keeps the doctor away. That's Dandy Boy Apples. Fresh, delicious, and dandy every time. Pick up a box today. Our tale begins in the rural hills near Grafton, where locals have reported a strange creature lurking in the woods. Robbie Cockrell and Peggy Mansfield were out on a date, celebrating Peggy's birthday. A full moon loomed large as they drove.
Robbie, you're going too fast.
Don't worry. This nuclear roadster handles like a dream.
Where are you taking me anyway?
I told you, it's a birthday surprise.
Way out here in the woods? There's nothing this far out of Grafton. Except that hospital by the river. Wait, I bet we're going to that new drive-in over in Clarksburg, right? Just so you can show off your slick new hot rod.
Ah, come on. Don't be like that, Peggy. I just thought the drive-in would be romantic.
Oh, Robbie. Robbie, look out!
Okay, Peggy?
Yeah. I'm okay, I think.
What hat?
There was a huge boulder in the middle of the road. I tried to warn you, but it was too late.
Look, in the road. There's nothing there.
How could that be? I saw it plain as day in the headlights. And just look at the front end. It smashed right in. I mean, it didn't just get up and walk away. What was that?
Probably just a wolf.
It didn't sound like a wolf to me. There it is again!
okay. Here, lean against me. There you go.
Will our two lovebirds survive such a harrowing ordeal? Tune in next time for the thrilling conclusion of The Beast of Grafton.
Century if it's the last thing I do. Since I have dirt on most of those yellow-bellied pissants, they won't have much of a choice. Tourism. That's what this place needs. Bunch of wide-eyed marks wandering around spending their cash on shit they don't need. Grafton Steel is the past. Water parks and shooting ranges are the future. But I have to be careful. Grafton Steel is a big campaign contributor. Can't let them think I don't have their backs. At least not until I stab them there.
Welcome to Grafton. I bet you weren't expecting a computer to be Grafton's mayor. Well, let me tell you, I used to be the mayor's assistant, but when he stopped showing up for work, I ran for office. I am eminently qualified, and the town unanimously elected me 1-0. Unfortunately, you are a wee bit early for tourist season. But this is your lucky day. Help us get ready for the upcoming flood of eager tourists, and I'll knock a whole 5% off the cost of all attractions. We have 4 major attractions around here. Wavy Willard's, the Clarksburg Shooting Range, Prickett's Fort, and a Black Bear Hunting Lodge. Go out there and get each of them ready. I'll wait here, because I don't have legs, and I can't move.
You'll need a variety of components to make all those repairs. Be sure to scrounge around for them.
Disappear! No fair!
Chapter of The Beast of Grafton. When last we left off, two teenagers, Robbie Cockrell and Peggy Mansfield, were running for their lives after a harrowing car accident, trying to escape a frightening creature stalking them.
See? You're doing great. Just like when we won that three-legged race in the park. We're almost to the hospital.
More agreeable than the
I don't understand.
Oh, you will, my boy. You both will.
Who are those men with guns? What is this place? Hey, let go of me!
What's happening? I feel so strange.
Grumpy.
Several things. You can't always trust a good Samaritan. Be cautious when driving through the woods near Grafton. And birthday wishes don't always come true. Be sure to tune in next week for another thrilling chapter of Tales from the West Virginia Hills.
Come on. Thank you. You there. You're here to find Freddy? His father. He put a tracker on Freddy that the lovely boy could not remove. But on that terrible day, it stopped. The policemen, they tried. It was simple. Clues were found here. Then came all of this. My Freddy, he was not found. He could live, no? You live, so he could. Such a clever boy. Now, maybe a man. Such a long time to wait for word of mon petit chou. But Nanny, she cannot bypass privacy protocol. To enter, the security office is unauthorized. Maybe you can enter?
Thank you.
Again. I'm telling you, it was the mongrels of a storm the other day. Some fool programmed me to be agitated unless there are always fresh targets up. I could really use your help with that. Customers are limited to 3 cans of beer when shooting.
Thank you.
Okay. Time to die!
historical site. The curator will announce the next show. Please stand by. Prickett's fort is fun for the whole family.
Don't face the wasteland without the proper supplies.
It's Grafton Day in Grafton.
Requisitions now available. Welcome, citizen. I am authorized to trade supplies.